play a little more of an open style than Ken Hitchcock did in Columbus in the past years.
Boy, with a shot knocked down, here's a centering pass, and Huselius nearly had a break on it. Cleared along the boards, Vermette trying to hold it in, does. Bad angle shot, scores! An impossible angle, but Rick Nash finds a hole and ties the game at one.
And a huge break here for the Sharks. Or pardon me, for the Columbus Blue Jackets, as Rick Nash just throws this towards the net. And the one knee down play for goaltenders, I like it in tight. I don't like it when a player is this far away, because you, as you can see here, the puck found a hole between the pad and went in on Niedermacki, and Rick Nash, he just threw it towards the net and got rewarded for it.
It's Hayda, who moves to Huselius on the Vermette, right side for Nash at center. Nash, perfect feed. In comes Huselius on the left wing. He tried to feed instead of shooting, looking for Vermette, and the Jackets will score nonetheless. A redirected pass finds its way behind Hiller, and he'd like to have another attempt at that one.
For the second time this year, Rick Nash has scored without shooting directly at the goaltender. He got a little help from his friends, trying to hit backdoor, and here's Huselius. What a play by Vyshnovsky. But then, well, Huselius stays with the puck. Rick Nash forces the front of the net. It goes off of Marchand, I believe, and finds the five hole on Hiller, and the Jackets have taken a 2-0 lead. Right there, a little luck, a little bit of help, and it doesn't get any better than that in a 2-0 lead for the Jackets. That was Tony Ludman, not Marchand. And right off of the hand, he
sends it off the boards. Nash picks it up. Net empty. Fires and scores. His second of the night. Third of the season. That will ice it. And the Jackets will have their first home ice victory. And the first home ice win for head coach Scott Arneal.
Panthers came in. They were hungry and motivated. And here comes Columbus. Odd man rush led by Rick Nash. Nash shoots. Score! Rick Nash!
That is just what the Columbus Blue Jackets wanted to see. Rick Nash, they've been saying he's been working hard. They've been saying he's been generating chances, just has not been able to cash. It starts with Jakub Voracek knocking down a Hal Gill point shot. And Rick Nash loves that shot, low blocker. He has a deceptively long stick.
He will not forget last year, his first year in the National Hockey League. On his first games right here in Columbus at Nationwide. Drop pass here, Brassard in front, score! What a pass to Rick Nash, and the Jackets have tied it up, 1-1. Nash trying to keep it away from the Blues forward. Back is finishing a check on the Jackets captain, but it's Voracek carrying into the zone. Voracek, Mathot, Brassard, oh, what a pass, and then what a terrific stop from point blank range. The Jackets follow it up, and it's Rick Nash who beats Halak, and it's 3-0. Far side by one, Nash scores! Rick Nash buries the stash! What a play by Nash!
And the Kings have it to Doughty. Doughty to Williams. Williams shoots, blocked it on the way in. Shot at the empty net. Score by Columbus as Nash got to it. And it is now 5-3, and it looks like the Kings' unbeaten streak at home is going to be over.
Chips it in from the wrong side of the red line, but Derek Brassard gets to it first. Kept to the outside as he circled the goal. Sneaks it to Nash, who comes right down the slot and scores. Rick Nash coming late off the Columbus bench, and the Jackets strike first.
He'll take the puck up high. Nash for Strollman. Up on that right wing, that's Brassard. Here comes Nash off the wing, scores! I believe it went off a skate of a Shark in front, perhaps Dan Boyle, but the Jackets get a power play goal for the second consecutive game, and they've got the early lead.
Well, Rick Nash again, he gets a hold of that puck, and the one thing that he does, watch the patience when Nash gets a chance to have the puck, and he corrals it on that stick. He takes a look to see what he has, and then when he lets it go, you're exactly right, Jeff, it did ricochet in off of the defenseman. It looked like it's Danny Boyle and into the back of the net. And for Nash, how about 7 goals in the last 8 games, and the Jackets have taken a 1-0 lead.
His team leading 10th of the season at 3:31, a power play goal, and the Jackets, when they score first, have won 9 of the previous 10 games when that has occurred. Couture dumped by Brassard with a good solid hit. late in the shift. Broussard heads to the bench, as does Nash. Wrap around attempt, and then the back out of position, and Nash will score. Rick Nash circles the net. And with Nitamäki totally out of position, gives the Jackets a two-goal lead with his second of the night.
Well, you look, everybody is looking around right now and wonder what just did happen. There's no congratulations to Rick Nash. There's nothing happening in and around the net.
The officials are converging.
You see the play by Nash. He lets it go, and it goes right up underneath the crossbar. And this will be probably the best look that we'll see. Watch for the crossbar and then down. And oh, yeah, that goes
That's
right up
goal.
Underneath the crossbar and into the back of the net. Right underneath, you've got the back post, you have the netting, and then the crossbar itself. And that will definitely be called a goal, and that'll be Nash's 11th. But there wasn't a whole lot of celebration. And the nice thing that we have in the National Hockey League, Jeff, is that overhead look. And watch the puck up top.
No question.
Top shelf. Exactly where that peanut butter goes. Excellent job by Rick Nash directing it to the front of the net.
All four officials, two converged in this near corner, two out at center ice talking, and then they all huddled, and now it is under review. But really, make no mistake about it, that puck was in the net. I think Marlowe has it get away from him, and Marlowe, of course, eligible to play presented. The net is empty. R.J. Umberger on the Nash. Two goals of the night. Here's the hat trick with the empty net goal and the icing on the cake, the exclamation point, because for the first time in franchise history, the Jackets will win a game here in San Jose in regulation. Their last win here was in overtime, their only other victory way back in 2004.
Well, an excellent job, and it all started again right at the boards. Umberger able to be able to kick that puck. As Boyle tries to control it, it's bouncing. He can't control it. Good pressure there by Umberger. And then Nash, he's in all alone. And for the Jackets, they're going to walk away with a victory. And the only question mark right now is to be able to do a solid job defensively.
Let's take a look at the reaction of the Jackets bench as Nash ices it. The Jackets will sweep California. Time is two. Held off by Rusty Klesla. Nash handing to Broussard. Left wing Voracek. A full stride across the line. Voracek looks for Nash. Scores! Cross ice pass. Nash continues with a beauty. What a pass by Voracek. Now a six-game goal scoring streak. Nine goals in the six games. A nine-game point streak for the Jackets captain, who records his 13th goal of the year.
Scott O'Neill took this line aside and said, gentlemen, keep the game simple.
For Umberger, Nash will get a tip, but wide. Strowman, broken stick by Voracek. He's got to hustle back to the bench. Nash hangs on, scores! Power play overtime.
Motion, you've got the crowd involved. 46.1 seconds left. And a play right there. Nash is patient. He looked off, and then he let it go. He was going to look to see if he could hit back door, but he had a chance to look on that low stick side, and he beats Lettinen through a haze. What a job right there by Rick Nash. You said it, his first in seven games.
On to Jan Hayden. Hayden's clearing pass sent to center. Voracek knocked it down. Here comes Nash across the line. Nash now trying to go wide on Stoll. He'll play it off the net and score from below the goal line. Nash from an impossible angle is able to fire it home, and the Jackets have the lead. Avery.
Watch the net.
Pinned there by Vermette. 120 left. Top of the circle it goes. Lundqvist, he's got to get back into the net. Here's Nash now as Lundqvist hustles back. Nash in. Nash scores! Rick Nash carries the Jackets on his back here in the third period. From an impossible angle, it gives him the lead. And now that insurance goal.
To reassure, 544 games in the National Hockey League, the most by any Blue Jacket player. And this is highlighted by a highlight goal. Look at this one. How do you like me now, he says. They extend the lead by two. And what a goal by Nash, and you're right, Jeff, he did. He took it upon himself.
We have seen that time and time again. John Tortorella has called a timeout at the Ranger bench.
Take a look at the happy captain here as he's able to build on the go-ahead goal with this key third goal of the night.
Tomorrow in the driveway, kids are going to be practicing this move. How about pulling it from the forehand to the back, and look at the reach. You don't teach that, you practice it. And with a reach like that, it's an easy move for 61.
Rick Nash, back pass, Russell, tipped. Looked like it went off Regier's stick wide. Kostopoulos trying to free it, the Flames have been aggressive. Russell dishes off, Rick Nash, he scores! Nash ties the game with his 17th of the year.
He's having a tough second period. He's the one that caught the puck up to Chris Clark, and right there, foul is Nash beating.
Watch out, Lucelius gets behind the defense. Nash scores! Rick Nash with his first goal in 9 games on a perfect cross-goal mouth feed from Lucelius.
Karofsky checks him. Now the Blue Jackets back into the King zone. Here's Voracek in the slot. His pass left side with a man in front. Picked up there, a shot, and scored from the right wing side. Rick Nash picked the corner. Now, until that goal by Smith. Puck sent down in and stopped there by Quick. He didn't get it. Picked up by Voracek. Shot, save again. Rebound, score! And it's a one-goal game again.
Columbus won that draw. Back to Klitsam. He's got Nash. Top of the circle. Nash fakes. Now the goal scores!
Rather nonchalantly makes the stick save, and now Brewer one-hands it up the boards, but not out. Voracek with it. Broussard, and they score! Rick Nash, a power play goal! And the Blue Jackets, a huge goal to make it 4-2.
On to Husalius. Pass again redirected. That one maybe by Corey Perry. Just along the ice, Broussard, Nash moves in, fires and scores! Rick Nash on the power play!
On here to Broussard in full flight. Derek Broussard spins and turns, 13 goals on the year for Nash. He scores! From the right wing circle, almost to the goal line. A Broussard pass finds Nash, and it's 1-0 Columbus.
Boy, what a beautiful play by the Jackets. And you talk about the transition game of the Columbus Blue Jackets in Detroit on Friday night, and then again Saturday night against Edmonton. You see Broussard, a little curl up, and he knew exactly that he had somebody on the backside. Well, it's the captain, Rick Nash, and Nash does not waste any time in letting that shot go. His 24th of the season, and look at the positioning. He's ready, and I'll tell you what, that's vintage Rick Nash getting that puck away quick.
Called for it.
None.
Cheap shot, plain and simple. Here is Voracek. Moves in, Nash looks and scores! Great pass there by Voracek. And it's the Bulls and...
And how about they move up ice and they utilize the entire 85 feet across the ice. Tape to tape to Nash. Look at that angle! That is, again, Nick Nash at his best, being able to deposit it into the net. Budaj's not able to move over. His 25th of the year. His 16th point in the last 14 games. And an emotional captain.
Nash taking the board, check pass, gets behind the defense, walks in, shoots and scores! That is goal number 26 on the year, and what a pass by Jake Voracek. Quick transition, Jackets have their first lead.
This time, it's all forehand. Puck protection, utilizing the body, a little backhand, and then with the reach, there's not a whole lot that Lettinen could do. And here's the iso right on Nasher. As he does, he cuts back towards the middle, body protecting the puck, and in the same motion, the high backhand over the stick check of Lettinen. The Jackets have made it a 2-1 game.
Aaron sprawled in front to knock it down. Here's Derek McKenzie. His shot is wide. Kings came close to getting another one there. Now up the middle to Nash. He scores! Came right up the middle to Nash. It was all alone. And the game is tied 2-2.
Jackets captain sends it off the boards, continues to play the puck to the front of the net, jams it home! What an effort by Rick Nash, and the Jackets have the first goal of the game!
Fourth goal to go along with four assists. And this is what you want to do when you want to score. Put the weight back to the heels. Drive to the net. Utilize your size and then follow up. Don't ever turn away. You collect your own rebound. What a leader number 61 brings. And look at the celebration of the captain.
1 minute of play.
Jackets. Jake Voracek, right wing and across the line. The crowd on their feet. Nash fires and scores! Goal number 29! A power play goal, and for the second consecutive game, the Jackets get not one, but two power play goals.
Well, he's had about three hits this shift.
Well, you know, where most guys would peel away and not take that hit, Clutterbuck, he looks for that.
He's a finisher. Here's Nash in the slot. He shoots. He scores.
Well, speaking of finishers,
wow.
Yeah, that's the first goal in 12 games for Rick Nash. And as I said in our open, you don't hold guys like that off the board.
Right wing. This is Brassard. Looks the trailer. Shot and a goal. Rick Nash takes the Brassard pass. And the Jackets.
And of course, Stewart. And Shatton could go the other way, and a backhand shot and a goal.
The speed, and notice the breakout as they come up the ice. They have a three-on-three situation, but it's the speed of Nash on that left side. And as Brassard just lays that puck into space, again, a little forehand pass. Well, Nash does the rest. Good speed, good reach. He's able to beat Elliott, and the Jackets have taken a 1-0 lead.